Yes, Jeff. Hello, Jeff.
Yep.
I hope you can hear me now.
Yes.
Okay, so
Loud and clear.
today I really wanted us to talk about something quite simple, which many of us overlook a number of times. You share such kind of information, people disregard it because maybe I've not made it a premium. Eh? One thing that we know is you will know that a trend is strong if it keeps on breaking the next level, correct?
Right.
If you have a strong downtrend, one of the things you will spot is in a strong downtrend, support will always be broken. And in a strong uptrend, resistance will always be broken. And if a market is trending, you may not be able to catch a setup at the exact level. You know, we are used to taking a trade at support, right, for up, and a trade at resistance for down. Now, this is where you need to benefit from, the reversed roles. The reversed roles, as SNR reversed roles. In this case, you have. I may pick this guy at least to help us spot things. For example, you see what we have here. The blue dots are a support level was created. Market went up, eventually was able to break it. Now, this support that was broken actually becomes a resistance if market ever gets back there. Should be familiar with that concept. Moving over to the other side, this support, blue is support. This is simply a fractal indicator. It's based on fractals. And you know, fractals will give you one high and two bars on the left, two bars on the right, which are lower than the middle one. You know that. So when this support level was violated by this bearish candle, the market went down. If it ever gets back to that level, even with this candle, you realize a number of times it will respect that level. You'll be able to see that this support was broken when market went back to it. It was able to respect it. This one was broken. Market went back, was able to respect it. Here was broken and market went back in. In this case, not respected. Now, when we are moving up, what do you expect to be broken? Resistance. Support will be created. They'll be hanging. This is hanging support, hanging support, hanging support. Because the market is moving up, it will not come to your support. So in this case, you target the red lines. If they are broken like here, the market went back and respected it. This one was broken. This and this were very close, was broken. And we entered a ranging market for some time. Market closed a little bit above, then switched to a downtrend. Now again, no, nothing here. So a new uptrend starts. So we have that broken. You can draw that line. You can see that. Let me do some little bit of drawing to help us understand the logic. This level, this is the resistance, initially resistance, broken by a huge candle, respected here. Market came back and was able to respect it. There was a resistance here, broken. This is not a breakout because this candle is nullified. This breakout, this is the actual breakout candle. Market comes back to the same level and respects that. And then as we move on, I just want to show you a few things and you'll be able to see how you can benefit from that logic. Broken, market did not go down. So that was a serious, strong, strong breakout where you have nothing to do. Here, broken, respected for a while. I think that's it.
Okay.
And that seems to be the case across all time frames. So there's nothing like this is going to be on 1 minute or on 5 minutes. But generally, that's what happens. And that's when you are using a fractal indicator. You can do this manually if, for example, you don't want to do that. You can do that manually and draw your own levels. Let me hide the colors. So if I do that, I only have my 21 EMA. You know, I like using 21 EMA a lot. Okay, for by trend as a trend filter, you may have noticed that this was a swing level. Are we there? I like
Yep.
I like doing both. I like doing the body and the wick. You see a very strong candle break, okay? And the next thing you spotted is market came back to it, and this time around, this guy was acting as resistance, okay? Few more examples. There are cases where that level will not be respected, so it's not always that it will work, but it will work most of the time, and I'll show you. So as we move on, maybe around here you were able to spot this level. As your support was violated, market never came back. Here you may have spotted some resistance again. Respected a bit, fake breakout, market still obeys it. And now, Jeff, there is one thing I need to remind you. And I think that's why you sometimes, and sometimes we end up getting wrong setups. You need always to remember that a market cannot trend in the same direction always. So you will need reach a point where you'll spot something like this, where a market went back to that level, reversed, went back to the same level, reversed. Now, when you see a setup like this in a downtrend, you should be worried. Now, remember, we are in a downtrend. If we were to follow our EMA, we are in a downtrend officially. Now, in a downtrend, you expect to be trading lower. Now, I do not expect in the first place for you to even attempt taking a trade here. For one reason, you are going against the trend. Now, when you notice this and this, now that is what we call what? A double what? What of our concept called double bottom? Where a market makes comes to the same level twice and changes direction. So it came, a double bottom is also what we might also call a W shape. So came here, went up, came here, went up. Okay? It's a W shape. Now, when you spot a W like this, don't try to enter trade to the downside, because this is a bullish reversal chart pattern. It's a chart pattern, it's not a candlestick pattern. This is simply telling you that the bears pushed the market to this level, could not go below. The bulls took over. The bears tried once again, but they were stopped at the exact same level. Now that means bears are likely to give up. So from here, you see here, there were two candles, green, but here we have multiple of them all the way to resistance. And if you were to enter trade here for a put, surprise, nothing, it doesn't work. This, whenever you spot this, it means the trend is likely to change. Because remember, the logic of the trend is this. The logic of the trend is always this. If you are moving down, you will go down, move up a little, go further down, move up a little, further down, move up a little. Now, when you start seeing, stopping at the exact same level, and then you see probably the same level, what are you expecting? There's a support there, right? Yeah, you expect the market to push up now. Similarly, if you are in an uptrend, you should expect market making a swing high, come down, a swing low, another swing high, another swing low, probably respecting the previous one, another swing high, coming a little bit down to almost where the other one was. But now you will reach a point where you'll notice the market will go either stop at the exact level or slightly below and then move down. Now, when you start seeing this discrepancy, that price was not able to go above the previous level, it means the bulls are tired. The uptrend is weak. Now, what you expect to happen is at that exact level, if the market breaks, goes back to this level, and gives you a signal, now you start trading a downtrend. Now, don't forget that, because that's very important in whichever strategy you use. You know, clearly we will always say follow the trend, but you cannot follow the trend blindly, because the trend will not last forever. Of course, even using moving average, you can see the trend was able to begin from here all the way up, but eventually it went down. Can you see what happened from what I'm explaining? This will save you a lot of OTMs. The market picked up from here, made a swing high, came down, made a level slightly higher than this, as you can see, slightly higher than the left one, came down. Now look at the next level. exact same level as the previous one. That tells you the bulls are tired. The uptrend is dead, in short. Okay? And if you were to convert it into a downtrend, you would wait for this low to be broken. So this is your low. So market breaks below, confirming now the downtrend is beginning, comes back and respects that low. Now you can start going down. And if you are to follow that downtrend, then you would start from here. You will still spot that the market started from somewhere here. Let me pick that arrow. The market started from somewhere here. Let's even pick it from here. Started here. Or the trend, you know, it's always a higher, it's a lower high and a lower low. So the lower high is here. So started here. So let's say we went down like this, pushed up a little bit, then pushed further down, pushed up, pushed down, but to where? To the previous level. So what do you expect? The trend may not continue downward. Look at that, for real. The trend did not continue. The trend just stopped. So here, when you see this happening, don't continue taking puts. Don't continue taking puts. Actually, in our case, we had a triple bottom. You know, there's also something like that, because market reversed here, stopped here, stopped here. The bulls are saying, no, you can't go lower than this. Now, if you scroll the chart, you might also realize they also came. They tried here. Eventually, they overpowered these bulls that were lying here. And the market went slightly down and then was able to go. You will not be able to see a trend changing without observing that. Almost every other time, there is that. Market comes the same level and stops. There is that. Okay? Market will not change just like that. That's what I explain. If I go back anywhere randomly, you will be, and it's important you grasp the idea, because it might save you unnecessary OTMs. There are cases where I've also lost trades, and only to check back and realize I didn't observe the trend was getting weak. For example, now look at this. This is a very sharp trend going up. A very sharp trend going up. And if I were to try to put in a sharp trend, you'll not be able to get those clear swings. So we started here a little bit, went down, pushed up, went down. I can actually say pushed up, went down, then pushed up. Probably as a single candle, doesn't look very nice. Then maybe went down, pushed up a little bit, went down, pushed up, went down, pushed up, went down. Do you notice what's happening now? Do you see how you spot end of a trend? Because now, let me show you, if you're having issues, that was the first peak. This peak is higher than this. This peak is near this, and so you would expect the break of this for you to consider downtrend. But now this one was violated and a new peak was formed. So that means the trend continues. Another peak forms above this. That means the uptrend continues. Another peak forms, the uptrend continues. But the next peak is now lower than the previous. That gives you a warning. Market is not going to sustain its move to the upside. But before it gave you this swing, it also gave you a low. Every swing has a low. You know that. There's a higher, there's a low, there's a higher, there's a low. Everywhere. Okay? So this was the low. Higher low, higher low, higher low, higher low, higher low, higher low. This was a high, higher high, higher high, higher high, higher high, higher high. These are like a double high. Okay. Now, what you noticed that should give you a warning. Ideally, what I'm saying, Jeff, is this. If you had identified a support here, if this was your support, two bar reversal. Remember, we're using a two bar reversal, okay? Strategy number one, we're using a two bar reversal, bear bull. When you see the market go up but without breaking above this, it tells you if it comes back down, it's likely to break this level. Very likely. a strong market will keep on breaking resistance, because each of these points is a resistance. Resistance, 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 resistance. So if an uptrend cannot break resistance, that uptrend is tired. And if it's tired, you will either enter a range. Usually that's what happens a number of times. You'd see market fluctuating here, moving up a little bit, just like that, just like that, just like that, before it finally goes down or it continues up. And you're familiar with this, because this is a distribution area. Okay? In a distribution area, if the bulls are stronger, they'll still break and continue upward. But if they are weak, the bears will become stronger and break to the downside and begin a downtrend, or what we call a markdown. So it is important, even when you are using the other strategy, you take note of these trends, because sometimes you will get a very nice setup, but you are not aware the trend is ending. So you will pick your setup and you lose that trade very easily. Very, very easily. Look at that, for example. You know, when you start spotting that, market stopping at the same level here, and you had drawn your level like this, and you saw a breakout, and you are waiting for a candle to come and touch here and make an entry, you should be worried. You should not be taking setups like this. The market was able to stop here with four candles. Couldn't it move up? Couldn't move up? It's simply telling you, you can also treat that as a small version of a double top. Up, down, up, down. Well, what do you expect when you see a double top? Reversal to the downside. So don't expect much from there. And again, another filter for technique number one is if you see the candle is too long too, also, it also warns you. Because too long candles are either exhaustion candles or they are momentum candles that can begin a trend. So anyway, that's that. Today I want to share something simple also that you can consider using together with what you already know. And if I'm able to remember, I'll be able to share several other techniques. So number one, I would like you to spot one thing. In an uptrend, bears are weak. In an uptrend, bears are weak. In a downtrend, bulls are weak. You should be familiar with that concept, okay? And so, one of the things I would like you to start spotting is simple. Pin bars are very strong candlestick patterns. We have a pin bar here. Do you agree? Let me just adjust this so that I can.
I'm having a lag. Yeah? I don't know why.
Sorry?
I'm having a lag.
Oh, there is a delay.
Yeah.
Oh, maybe it's now evening. People are using the internet so much.
Yeah.
Okay, I was trying to show you a setup here just to explain my concept. I think I lost that, but we can pick from anywhere. I was explaining that in a downtrend, you will notice that bulls are weak, bears are very strong. Even if you are to observe from here, assuming this is the beginning of a downtrend, price is now below the moving average. Okay? Let me make this line thicker so that we are able to see it. Right? That's better?
Okay.
Fair enough, right? So things are clear now. You will notice we have entered a downtrend. We have a momentum candle. The bulls are trying to go up also. Then we have another strong candle to the downside. The bulls are trying to go up. Then what did you notice? Here. Do you see something there? Here. Let me make it bigger even. What kind of candlestick pattern is this?
Pin bar.
Which pin bar? Bearish, bullish?
Bearish.
Okay. Remember, it's a bearish pin bar, even if it's green, because the pressure from the upside is so strong. And that means in the fight, in the struggle, the bears were stronger than the bulls. When you see this pattern forming on a moving average, it is a safe entry for the next candle. Where is that guy? Safe entry for the next one. Sorry?
On the 21 EMA.
This is 21 EMA. You can also try others. I like using this on 21. If you see a pin bar being rejected from a moving average, the next few candles will go in the direction of the rejection. This is a bearish rejection. We'll enter immediately for a few candles. Could be one, could be two, three. When you do your backtest, you'll be able to be comfortable with one or two or three. If you are doing it on 30 minutes or 15, it can be just one candle. Okay? So that is one. I'll just show you a few more examples. Remember, we are looking at a bearish signal on the moving average during a pullback. The market came down strongly. It's trying to go back up to the moving average. And that is a bearish signal. So clear that up. Let's move down. Now the market moves down significantly, goes back up. What do you spot here? What kind of candle is this? A doji, right?
Yeah.
A doji that could not break, could not close above the moving average. That also tells you you can enter the next. Let me give you four more examples. This works across. Of course, you'll be able to lose what you need to be careful that the signal is appearing on the moving average, not closing above.
Okay.
You know the line is just a line. It doesn't have to be, because a close above like this is worrying. When you see a candle closing like this, it's worrying. If you see a gap, it means price might fill the gap. What I want is a setup that's clear, that you will be able to see there was rejection. Look at that. There was a rejection from the buyer, from the sellers at the top. And remember, you need to identify the pin bars correctly. A pin bar must have a very long wick. And in most cases, the downside may not have a wick, because the downside having a wick means even the buyers have issues. You need to have it, the wick from the top only meaning there is selling pressure, not buying pressure. Okay? Because if you have a wick from below, it means the market might continue moving up. I'll give you a few more examples. And I think now with your experience, you should be able to pick some other setups without necessarily worrying much. I just don't like seeing it closing above significantly. Look like this. Half of it is above, half of it is below. In that case, you don't. So now we are in an uptrend. What kind of candle is this? Another doji, right?
Okay. No, I have a lag. Yeah, it's a doji.
Yes. And you see what happened next. Those patterns are everywhere. Those patterns are everywhere. Let me change to M15. I've changed my time frame. So you could just be trading other setups and you spot that. Market breaks above, rejects. Market breaks above, moving average, meaning we started an uptrend, rejects with a pin buy again. I hope you are able to see the exact rejections I'm picking, not just any. This is a case where you can have a problem because of the gap I told you. Remember the gaps?
Mm-hmm.
And so when you see there's a gap, chances are you take like three candles now, because one candle might stay close above before the reversal takes place. Look at how this one is very close to the moving line during a pullback. Broke up, confirming an uptrend begins, comes down and rejects the moving average and forms a very weak candle. I'll be able to give you a few more setups. Look at this. There's a gap. You can take three candles. Now Jeff is looking at me and saying, Bernard, where do you get these things? Look at that. It didn't touch the line, so slightly a gap. You can take several candles. This is not a valid pin bar, you know that? Is it like a spinning top, kind of? I'm not talking about such kind of candles. We broke above, came back, rejected this. You see, that's why I was telling you, take like three candles, one, two, three, in which case that would have been a winning trade. But if you try to take one after this bearish, you see the next candle went down fast before the reversal. So very good ones we close at the exact level. And if it closes above the line, you don't take a put. This one closed above. So that makes it a wrong setup. And again, from the downside, you expect the weak from to be from above, not from below. So always remember, it is you are following what? What are you following? A pullback. In other words, price must go up, then come to the moving average for you to consider taking a bullish pin bar. All right? If you're in a downtrend, price must move down, then come back to the moving average for you to look for that pattern to give you a signal. Like here, price started here, went all the way up, a few candles, you see, came back here. This a pin bar, okay? This a pin bar. One problem I told you with such kind of pin bars is what? The top rejection week. Can you see that week?
Yes.
Yeah, there's a long week also at the top, which actually says there's selling pressure, there's buying pressure. Such setups are not very good. Now look at this, a near perfect setup. And we saw something like this earlier on. I guess you can see it. Look at this setup. Rejection from the bottom. There's no rejection from the top. Okay. Those are some of the excellent setups you can get. They will win almost always. Almost always. And if you see something like this, the long wick at the top, clearly saying sellers are having a lot of pressure here. So I noticed, I told you, if there is a gap, you wait. If there's a gap, one candle will go up. So in that case, you would consider taking more candles than just one. And ideally, you don't trade that setup. Your entry should be where? The moving average. Your entry. The actual moving average. So you don't do an immediate entry when you see a gap. You would wait for price to come to that level. Let me get a drawing tool. To come to that exact point where the moving average, because of the gap between where the candle is and the moving average. Immediately the next candle goes to the moving average, then you make your entry for three candles, four candles or so. So I'm sure when you start back testing, you'll be more comfortable with your own expiry time. But the alert is, if it closes exactly at the level, you are free with one candle. But if there is a gap, you need to wait a little bit for price to come to the same line, or you make an entry for multiple candles. That's when you will have a safer entry. All right. So, and sometimes when you get experienced with this technique, you will not be trading pin bars only. You can actually trade other patterns. I'm just giving you insight into this. Look at this small pattern here. Can you see that? Only the wick is below. There is no top wick. You can't see much of a wick at the top. Price bounces the other side. A few more setups. And you know, the beauty with the price action is you can trade it on any chart time frame. So if I'm 30, you can still do, you can see that kind of setups. One is here. So the closer the pattern is to the line, the better the signal. The better the signal. Okay. A few cases you will lose, like here. And of course, you understand why you are going to lose that setup, most likely. We are having a short downtrend here instead. I told you, when you start spotting, this was a swing high, the next swing high is lower than this. That means trouble. Where else? You get these setups if you see a sloping moving average, slanting upwards like this. That means the trend is very strong. So when you see something like this, there's a gap, a little gap, and with the wick at the top, you wait for price to come, touch, then you can actually make your entry for three candles or so. Otherwise, you can avoid the setup if you don't like the wick, because the wick also communicates things. A small doji can also be traded, like here. But you see, I don't like the wick at the top. Such setups, you can actually avoid with, and you know, don't mess yourself. The most ideal setup is, if you are going up, the wick below must be very long. If you are going down, the wick above must be very long.
Yes, yes.
So that's called, it's called a pin rejection, pin EMA rejection, or a pin bar EMA rejection strategy. Now, it is just that, but remember, moving averages smooth out price action and can also be used as dynamic support and resistance. That's exactly one of the things we are trying to do. And if I went back to maybe a different pair, pound dollar, maybe M5 again. One of the things you can notice is there are patterns that form on the moving average over and over again. Over and over again. And you can also trade them the same way you trade other techniques. Now, if you look at what we have on our chart, for example, you spotted a Morningstar here, which went successful for several candles. Okay, there was a little bit of a gap down. You know, there's a gap between the red and the next red. Then later on, price went up, came back to the line, and gave you another Morningstar, which went on successfully. You can see that? Later, price comes to the moving average and gives you another Morningstar. You follow it. You might be saying there's magic. We can go anywhere and we'll be able to spot that. You can just be able to, you read what the chart is telling you. If it's giving you similar patterns, you trade those patterns. Here, I only see this. There's no confirmation. I need similar patterns on the moving average for me to be able to proceed with taking the setup. So this is like a second strategy to the same. The other one was just pin, but here you can take others. Now remember, as a moving average, which is like a dynamic support and resistance, you can actually use it to pick setups. For example, when you spot this, the market strongly up, comes back and gives you a bullish reversal pattern, you can still consider taking a setup from there. Well, remember, the pattern did not break below. Look at the wicks. Look at the wicks. Each of the three candles rejected the moving average. Then you will be able to see similar setups. You will be able to see similar setups. Only I'm scanning very fast. Also, look at this. It's a Morningstar. Week, week, week. None of the candles closed below. And you see we are going well. Then if you were to go where now, let me show that I can get another setup. You just need to be careful not to close below. Here is another setup. This one did not touch though. In fact, the three did not touch. So that's not a very safe. Look at this one. A variation of the Morningstar again. Week below, touch, up. Look at this one. Touch, touch, touch. The Morningstar is resting on the moving average. So when you hear people say moving averages can act as support and resistance, look at that evening star on the moving average here. So long as you are sure the body is not closing above, of course your eyes will be able to help you with that. There are cases where it may not work. There are cases where it will work always. Like now here we have a range, obviously. And we don't see a valid pattern here. Okay? This is not valid because these candles did not actually touch. Only one was able to touch. So I like those that are rejecting from the same level. Here only two are able to touch. And here if you entered, you would have just received your money back because that's an ATM, a draw. So I think those should be good setups. Ideally, when you see all the three touching, you see when you see two, there's a problem in most cases. When you see only two touching, I like all the three, like here. Touch, refuse, touch, refuse, touch, refuse, then you can go.
Interesting.
Is it? Yeah, that is the market for you. Yeah, here there was a minor close above. I would still say you should be worried about this kind of setup. Eh? Although with the price action technique, you will always consider taking this setup. Reason being, the pattern formed on resistance. Remember the two bar reversal resistance here? Stopped. You can still consider. So you can even include support and resistance from the two bar reversal patterns we talked about. You see, none of these three touched. So you'll have a problem. You try to pick a signal if the line, the candles did not touch your level. So that is that. This pattern also works even though it closed below. Why I would be comfortable with this perhaps, although it closed, there was a long week. This one, a long week. This one went back above, which means at the base of this pattern, there is a support and resistance. And for sure, I see one. Can you see that? From the body to the wick. from the body to the weak, go back to the left, support, resistance, resistance. So when you see that kind of pattern forming and you feel like you don't want to wait for the exact match, check if where the pattern formed, there was a previous support and resistance. For sure, resistance, resistance, and support, that gives you a guarantee price will continue moving up. So you can still add support and resistance as a key filter. In any case, where you see these patterns forming, there is always a support and resistance. Market will never change direction without such. So you saw this happening on the moving average. You just confirm whether there was a resistance or a support. What do you see? There was a morning star here formed. Market reversed to the upside. This is what we were calling what? The bullish two bar reversal pattern, which also gives you a support and resistance. Actually, you could have even drawn it the other way around, body to weak. And you realize the pattern formed from there and closed below the zone, meaning market can actually continue going up. So, my friend, that is it.
Interesting.
And this works across time frames. I've shown you examples from 30, 15, 5, 1. So it's up to you to decide what to do with it. So now I think you have about, I would say in my estimation, you have about 7 techniques, if you are able to record them carefully, which you can analyze on your own and decide which one you think you are more comfortable with to start trading with as soon as you can. Okay? And remember now, a number of these strategies can be traded together. For example, while you are on M5, while you are waiting for the first technique, remember the first technique breakout with the touch. While you're waiting for that setup to happen, you can also spot this candlestick pattern forming on the moving average. While you are waiting for that to happen, you can also see a pin bar bouncing from the moving average. So with just a single indicator, this EMA 21, you can trade the rest of the techniques. Maybe as you are waiting for things to happen here, maybe you spotted this bear bull, then you saw bear bull, then you saw. By the pattern we were describing the other day is also here. Red, red, green, red, red, green, red, red, green. So there are really many things you can do with just a clean chart like this. So you don't have to use indicators, but if you want to use indicators, that is still fine. I can tell you some of the systems I'm working on are extremely, extremely, extremely powerful, and they're based on indicators. Now, because you are part of the college, I think I'll be able to showcase some of this to you when the time comes. I'm building techniques from time to time.
Programmed. Let me ask. Let me
give you a demo of one. Hold on, I give you a demo of an indicator-based technique. So I'm going to stop sharing as well as I load the chat, and then I'll show you again. Just don't disappear. Yes, I hope you are there.
Yes, yes.
Now, these are unique bands of mine that I'm testing on a number of things. And I think I'm getting satisfied with the results a little bit, but I am yet to speak about it because I need to be very comfortable with it. I notice with these special bands of mine, if a candle closes officially above, then for 3 candles, I am in. So that would be a good setup for me here. 3 candles down, that would be an ITM. And then I just want to see the candle close completely outside the body. I can see here, the red closed, the both sides are down. For 3 candles, that would be a valid setup also. I just want to pick such setups. They are there. You can see the body of the candle is down. The next 3 candles reverse to the other side. Look at this candle here. If I took 3 candles, that would be an ITM. Look at this ITM. Look at this ITM. Look at this ITM. Look at this. I don't like the way it's closed. I need to see it close outside, really. Yeah? Because I want to cheat. I want to see the body outside. And when I see that, I should be happy with an entry. So, yes. So that is a lot. There's one here that loses. Okay. Oh, three candles would have been an item. This one. Three candles would be an item here. Okay.
No, my problem, there's a lag, so I have to wait to see.
Oh, I was giving you an example. I thought this one was a losing trade. The red candle closed outside, and I thought I was going to lose three candles later, but I noticed it closed above here. Because price opened here, closed here. For three candles, I'm talking about three candles. So if I move,
that's a 19.
Now you see, you also spot something like this. Clear, close outside, three candles, you are good to go. Some cases are a little bit tricky, whether it's actually closed outside or not closed outside. So if you are comfortable, you know, waiting for the sure ones, where you see a larger part of the candles outside, like here. Okay?
Yeah.
That will guarantee you a setup you can win. So apart from trading price action, I believe in automating some of my strategies. There's another setup here. So I believe in automating some of the techniques. And that's why maybe when you are in my group, you'll be able to see. Sometimes I tell people, use what you are comfortable with. If you are comfortable with indicators, use them. If you are comfortable with price action, use it. If you are comfortable with volume, use it. If you are comfortable with all the three, combine them. It's up to you. What matters is you will be a profitable trader.
Exactly.
Because what is the point of calling yourself a price action champion and you are losing? What is the point of calling yourself an indicator champion and you are losing? If I'm trading with indicators only and I'm making 70%, 80% win rate, who cares? I think that's the mindset I want you to have, so that you don't get swayed by people who say indicators will blow your account. No, that's never true. Because when you build an indicator, you build it from price. These candles. So whoever is trading the candles and whoever is trading the indicator, they are trading the same thing. They might say, someone might say that, price action indicators lag. There's no problem, but you need to know how to use them, because even I told you, support and resistance also lags. You cannot draw support and resistance on future candles. You have to draw it on past candles. The only thing that does not lag is volume, actually. Because volume, you will see it happening. You'll see it happening and we'll be able to tell you the future is like this. And the time does not lag. So there is also a technique based on time. I don't know, maybe we're not shared, but there's a technique based on time. Maybe later on I will be able to unfold what it is. But for your information, you can be able to see, that a number of times. Have you ever spotted, maybe I mentioned this, have you ever spotted 9 candles in a row? Have you ever seen 9 candles in a row? Going in the same direction?
Nine.
Yes, subsequent or consecutive.
I've not been keen though.
Okay, let's try to see whether they are around here. In this section, let's see whether we can spot one. From here to here, how many candles do you see? This might be very many. This might be very many. I'm seeing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And the market was reversing, gave you a doji. Okay, so, just a moment, I'll load again something here to show you what I was trying to say. Okay, I was trying to show you that you can also use time to trade. But later on, I'll be able to teach you guys how you can use time to trade. Markets have weird behaviors. If you spot 9 candles in a row, actually, or even 8 candles in a row, chances are the next candle will change direction. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. The next one was not a candle. 8. See? I don't know whether this is going to give us 8 candles in a row. These are 7. I've observed that in the market. If you see 9 or 8 in a row, the next one will change direction. Many times. So serious scandals, not dodges or stuff. So this one messed up everything. So we can start 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. What do you notice?
Bad.
Yeah, I was not cooking the results. I'm just telling you what I've observed from the market. If you're in the market for long, you'll be able to see these things happening. And that's why martingaling is dangerous. Huh? Martingaling is very dangerous. Yeah, the pattern is messed up because there are bears inside bulls. But you can go and back test on your own. You'll be able to observe that. 9 is a very powerful number in the market. 9 is a very powerful number. That whenever you have a sequence, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, messed, 6, 7, 8. So if you are included in this one, that would have been the 9th candle, and you see the market misbehaving after that. So it's a pattern that I've observed. The reason you may not be able to trade this as a strategy on its own, unless you are using a robot, you can't keep waiting for this pattern to happen. You can see me scrolling for so long before you can get one. But you should be aware. So in case you are waiting for a setup and you are seeing 9 candles forming, then you can also consider that as a setup. Look at that. Or we saw this. I don't think so. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. You see? Price must do something after the 9th candle. Wow. All right, Jeff. I think those are enough techniques. You can document them. I'll share the videos with you. Are you an active trader? Because I would also like you to be to help me with managing the group as well, if you are comfortable with that.
Active to mean what?
Are you active, actively in the market, or you work most of the time and you're not able to share stuff?
I'm active in the market.
Oh?
I'm active in the market.
You're active, eh?
Yes, I spend quite a number in the market, quite a number of hours. I spend quite a number of hours in the market.
Okay. Right, then I would expect you to be a little bit more active. You know, some Kenyan traders around. I was thinking of organizing a workshop for Kenyan traders.
For binary options, yeah?
And Forex, yes. Yeah. Now we are talking off camera. I will have to clear, remove that clip. Yeah. Yeah. So I was thinking of doing that. And I believe at this point.
Yeah, what I'm aware of is, I know there's a community I was in. I'm thinking of going back.
Uh-huh.
There's a, I don't know whether.